Hello everyone, my name is Debbie John Snyders and I'm from the Hopedale Presbyterian Church. Merry Christmas to our children and families. And today's lesson, wow. Christmas is coming. Today's story is The Birth of Jesus from Mission Bible Class, and the images are by Sweet Publishing and licensed by Free Bible Images. We have three coloring pictures today and two crafts. One is a nativity wreath and the other is a host of angels mobile. We also have a variety of activities for you, including mazes and word searches, crosswords. So today we're going to learn about a very special baby. This is a baby who was sent especially by God. His mother's name was Mary. And can anyone guess who his father was? The baby is the Son of God. Today we are going to learn about how God sent his own son as a special gift to everyone in the world. Joseph and Mary were married and lived in the town of Nazareth. God had chosen Mary to be the mother of a very special baby who was the Son of God. Joseph was a good man and took care of Mary and her baby. While Mary was pregnant, she went to visit her much older cousin, Elizabeth. And when Elizabeth saw Mary, she felt the baby inside of her tummy move around. This was a happy day. In the future, Mary's baby and Elizabeth's baby would be cousins. They would be Jesus and John the Baptist. Joseph and Mary lived in a town called Nazareth. The Romans were in charge of the country. One day, the ruler of the country, called Caesar Augustus, sent a letter to Nazareth saying that all the people had to go to the city where their families came from. Every person in the family had to be counted. This was called a census. He wanted to know exactly how many people there were because he wanted everyone to pay taxes. Joseph and his family had come from a little town called Bethlehem. Bethlehem was a long way from Nazareth. Of course, there were no planes or cars back then. People had to walk or ride animals. Because Joseph and Mary wanted to do what the king commanded, they packed up their things. Mary rode on a donkey while Joseph walked beside her. They began their trip to Bethlehem. When they arrived, they found the roads very crowded with people. They looked and looked for a place to stay, but all the inns were full. It was growing very late. Mary was tired. It was almost time for her baby to be born. Joseph was also tired and needed a place to rest. God had not forgotten Mary and Joseph. Joseph saw a place kind of like a shed or a barn, also known as a stable, where the animals were kept. He led Mary where it was warm and safe. They were glad to find a quiet place to rest from their long journey. During the night, a wonderful thing happened. Mary had her baby. Mary was so happy. It was a son, just as God had promised. He was the Son of God. Joseph and Mary gave him the name of Jesus. Joseph looked for a place to put the newborn baby. He found a box full of straw. This was the kind of box the farmers put hay in so the animals could eat from it. It was called a manger. Mary fixed the straw and put a piece of cloth on it. Then she wrapped the baby up tightly and placed him in the warm straw. Outside the city, some shepherds were watching over their flocks of sheep in the quiet night. Suddenly, a great light filled all of the sky. They had never seen anything like it before. And in the middle of the light, they saw an angel. The angel spoke to them. He said, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all people. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloth and lying in a manger." All of a sudden, there was not just one angel, but many other angels. And they were praising God, saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace to men on whom his favor rests." When the angels went away, the shepherds left their sheep and hurried into the town of Bethlehem. The angel had said that the baby would be in the town of David. Everyone knew that another name for the town of David was Bethlehem. The shepherds found Joseph and Mary and the baby, just as the angels had said. They told Mary and Joseph all about the wonderful sight of the angels in the middle of the great light and the wonderful words they said. The shepherds were glad they found this special baby whose birth made even the angels happy. Of all the gifts that anyone could ever give, the shepherds knew that God's gift was the best. God had given this little baby, Jesus, to the world. Remember to thank God for the gift of his son, Jesus. Merry Christmas. At Christmas, we celebrate the birth of Jesus. The Nativity story is the story of Jesus, the Son of God. Jesus' birth fulfills the prophecies of the Old Testament. He is born of humble circumstances in a stable, and yet he is our King of Kings. We have several activities depending on your age level, interest, and ability. You will need to print the templates. There are 3 coloring pictures. There are 2 crafts. Now for your coloring activities and for your crafts, you'll need to have a variety of coloring implements. And you can choose to use markers or colored pencils or crayons, or if you want, you could even paint. So the first craft is the Nativity wreath. And you will need a plate, yarn, a hole puncher, the templates, scissors, glue, things to color with. And so I'll show you here is the template that you will need. So first you're going to decorate the 2 parts of the template. You can see there's the nativity scene and the bow. So decorate them however you like. Cut them out. And then you need to put a hole punch up here and tie cut yarn through the hole so you can hang this up. You can glue the nativity scene on in the center of the wreath, or you could staple it. I have stapled it. You could do either one. And once you have the picture glued on the back of the plate, then glue or staple the bow on. And there you have it. You can hang your wreath up on a door, for example, and tell everyone that God sent his son. The second craft is a host of angels mobile. So you will need a hanger, yarn, scissors, glue or tape, and the templates. And if you want to color things, you will need some coloring implements. So I'll show you the template. It is double-sided, and that's so the angels have a front and a back. So you can see how that works. So if you print this double-sided, then you don't have to glue two pieces together. It just makes it easier. So once you've decorated your angels, if you have a color printer, you don't have to. You can just use the colors. So once you've done that, cut the pieces out, glue the front of the angels to their backs if you haven't done it in a double-sided fashion. And you can see this strip here says, we can tell others about Jesus, and there's a dotted line and it's folded. And if the back side of it is here, and the instructions are written on the back. So you will want to cut different lengths of yarn or ribbon if you like, so that your angels can be at different heights. You also want to put a hole punch on either side here. Once you fold this bar, this strip with the announcement about Jesus, you can put a hole punch on either side and tie cut yarn, these would be equal pieces, to the hanger. So you now have this tied to the folded piece of the strip. So I haven't glued this as yet. You can use tape or you can use glue. But the idea is you want to fit all of the pieces of yarn here underneath the strip here that says we can tell others about Jesus, and today in the town of David, a Savior is born to, has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. So you're putting the yarn pieces in different lengths here and taping or gluing it. You then need to put hole punches for the angels and tie your cut pieces of yarn through. And I've done it with a number of them facing forward and some facing backwards so that you can look at your mobile from different angles. And there you go. We can tell others about Jesus. Dang that one up. Okay. we also have a variety of other activities. And we have a manger maze. And the pieces seem to be stuck together. We have word searches and mazes. A few of them, word searches and mazes. And we have a Christmas anagram where you can figure out what the missing, what the words are. For example, angels is here all mixed up. So I think it's probably that one. But you can figure it out and have fun doing that. This week, remember God is love and God gave us the gift of His Son to us. Let's all show each other love like the love our Father in heaven sent us in the form of Jesus. Wishing you and your families a very, very Merry Christmas. Have a great week.